get the quest. And that was already a bad run, so I'm just gonna end it. Continue. Spews out fire as long as you have stamina? How does it do that? Plus, I don't really know what you mean by broken.
Here we go!
Yeah, I mean, it's an item that you found. It's a good thing, right? I'm not sure how it spews fire, though. Like, I press the buttons. Maybe it's because I can't use it properly. No, I pressed the buttons. I wasn't doing that, but... Unless you need to not have a weapon on your right hand or something. Yeah, in order for that to happen, I need to be two-handing my weapon. So maybe I need to two-hand the shield. Has the highest defense for all attributes out of all the shields I've found so far. Nice. Well, it's a good thing that it's useful for you. I'm sure the twin bosses didn't cost you as much trouble as it cost me. Grandma quest. La 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 la. I'm here. You said rolling doesn't work properly in this game. Did it work? Wait, I never said that. Man, I never said that. Unless you're referring to me like saying I pressed the button and it didn't do anything, or I pressed the button and I'm still getting hit, you know, that's, I'm just joking. I mean, I'm sure if the game realizes that I dodged something and then I didn't dodge it, or vice versa, it's just how the game works, unfortunately. It's just annoying to press the button at the wrong time, I guess, but I don't know if rolling works any better or worse in this game or not. Elden Ring. I have no say in that. So I'm not sure where you got that, other than me just saying that for the sake of saying it. Double pumpkin fight? Yeah, but I mean, you have to press the dodge button at the right time. And there's also two attacks coming at you. So if you press the button at the right time for one attack, but the other attack still goes off, then, you know. That's just how the game works. You have two attacks, you have to avoid both of them in the right way. And if you don't, you just die. Yeah, that's just me talking for the sake of talking. You have to realize, when it comes to Dark Souls 1 and 2, and some of 3, because I never beat 3, Like, you don't have these tiny rooms with these bosses. Like, these bosses are just so big. You have a tiny room, and you have this huge boss, or in that case, you have a tiny room, and you have two medium-sized bosses, and you have to just traverse through that. Oh my lord. Like, it sucks. all the other Souls games, they don't do that. Or if they do it, you do like one or two and that's it. Right? Like, it's not something that the game focuses on. Yeah, and the other thing, like you mentioned, I'm not using these things that would make these fights easier to deal with. That's not really the game's fault, that's my fault. So instead of me making the game, I guess you can say, more fun by being able to use these cool spells, I decided not to use them. I need to read that. There's some stupid huge bosses on a very small space here too, you can fall off. Oh, in this game? Or where? Where is here? I was not confident on that, and I didn't want to die. Just like I'm not gonna do this skip here. I'll do those skips once I'm ready to do them. No! Yes, it's your fault for me dying. Hope you're happy. That's one. That's two. Such a weird starting point. I like the different iterations you have of that dude laughing. Jesus. The HP 2. So I'm gonna save here until my next PB, then I'll just stop saving. I'll stop saving, or I'll stop saving at the entrances and save only midway. So like midway through dungeon 4 and 5. Although dungeon 5 doesn't need it. If you die, that's kind of a game over anyways. Dungeon 4 definitely needs it. Do that. I should be able to take a hit from that skeleton with HP 5. Yeah, do this. So then I can do this. No. I'll save, but I thought I needed to do something here, but no. Yeah, see, I don't even kill any of them, so there's no point on doing that. Although I could use lightning. Could use lightning there. I was like, damn, I'm gonna get a massive gold here, and then I remembered. Hey, look at that, 4 second gold. Yeah, so I don't need to save for Dungeon 3 either. Quest. Here's the thing, right? I could choose to get a mana potion right there. Could choose to get a mana potion there. Which it would cause less waiting.
Well, less waiting, and you'd be able to cast Holy Spell again. Yeah, I should definitely buy the mana potion there. It's only 25 gold. Oh my lord. Thank you. Let me see, do I have enough XP for power 5? I don't. Power 5 is 5,000. So I would have to get it midway. Don't kill me! Great. Okay, I'm just gonna... I'm just gonna do that. So no entry power 5, it's gonna have to be halfway through. That moment when you press the jump button and nothing happens. Or something did happen and then somehow I also ended up not avoiding death. Holy crap, holy man, they are really gunning for me. Don't do that. Wait. Really, dude. Do the eyeball. Do the eyeball. It really took a sweet ass time to die, man. Pressing the wrong button. Not really sure why that took longer, but I don't really care. Thank you. Yo, how's it going, Serenix? Just in time to probably see a failed speedrun. Damn it, go up. Thank you. Nice. Not nice. Playing LOL? Okay, that's a weird choice. I know what LOL is. Thought you said it in a questioning way. I guess you were questioning the choice. Yes, I was questioning the choice. That is definitely an interesting choice there you got there. Spice things up. I mean, good on you, man. Wait. I just remembered something. Well, I mean, if I don't die, this will be a PB. How long have you been playing LOL? Is this like a first time? Is this like... you pro? You making me think otherwise? That probably didn't fully hit him, but then again, I had to dodge two freaking flame balls in my ass. You that triple, quadruple platinum. started to play it like last year. Oh, okay, okay. But then I quit after a week. Yeah, I probably lost one cycle here. I'll be surprised if this next one kills him unless I die first, of course. Hey, he died. I started to play it like last year, but then I quit after a week and now I'm getting more into it. I'm not leveled up enough to play right. Yeah, this is a new world record right here. Unless the final boss kills me 5 times or something. Probably even less than that. Saving even though I don't need it. Yeah, I played League of Legends for probably a few months. I wanted to say a month, but no, I think I played it way longer than that. A few months. I was basically being told, yeah, if you choose, like, the most basic free character ever, your ass is gonna get pounded. And I'm like, so what's the point on these characters being there if no one ever chooses them? What's the point on, you know, like, breaking... breaking the way it's quote-unquote played. Or not being able to break the way the game is played. If you want us to play in a certain way, holy crap. So I mainly did... Oh my Jesus! Couldn't even finish what I was thinking because this guy's like, I'm gonna kill him. Oh my gosh. Oh, that was so funny. Anyways. Yeah, I was, what I was saying was, like, I was just getting told by the people that had been playing League of Legends at that point for a while, that you can't just choose, like, the dude with the giant sword, I don't know what his name is, like, you can't just choose Anna, the little girl with the giant bear, because people will pound you. I'm like, I don't get it then. I don't know what his name is. I have no idea. Like, for instance, you have, like, the heavy tanks that go up. And then you have, like, the ranges that go down. And then you have, like, the rogues that roam around in the middle. I'm like, so what if you put a freaking range with a tank? Aren't you going to destroy him? Because he's obviously not equipped for that? Or vice versa? Like, what if you put the tank in the middle? Freaking, you might be able to outmatch the rogue, like, at the start of the game, because he's no way, he won't be able to take the blows. But so I stuck around with ARAM. I thought ARAM was awesome because it's just one lane and it's, you're just kind of like dancing until you go, and it's, I don't know, I found it really cool. The only reason I stopped playing it was kind of like everything else. I had no one to play with. You've always been able to pre-select whatever it is you wanted to play. Like, if you're in a team, then it's like, oh, well, I'm top. Oh, well, I'm this. Oh, well, I'm that. Oh, and if you're first, choose this character. And it's like, okay. But if you're playing with randoms, then you just have to hope that you get your character, because apparently you can switch characters. I don't know. Well, I'm not referring to the very first season, man. I played League of Legends, like, way after it was out. I don't even know what season 1 looked like of that game. I could care less. Yeah, it's been like that since I was playing it. Yeah. It's been like that since I played it. Yo, also, I'm not ignoring you. Mr. Scott Free with the gifting out one tier one sub to Timmyverse, man. I really do appreciate that. Really does mean a lot. Yeah, I finally saved the 4 minutes that I lost in Pyromancer, which is Stormheim Castle. And then from there, everything just went perfect. Apparently, I've lost like 30 seconds from entering Dungeon 4 up to Lord Cowfish. I might have ended up dying. Because dying would definitely answer the question. But from there, everything else was perfect. So basically,